My name is Pranay Singh.
And my name is Harmeet Singh Chabra.
And we are from Mahanadi. So the topic for our presentation is downfall of Motorola.
So before starting our presentation, I just want to clear one thing. I'm having a really bad throat today, so I won't be able to speak nicely. And also I'm holding the mic for the first time in my life. So I'll blame the mess community for the bad throat. They've been keeping ice creams all day. So I should just start my presentation. So I just want to ask one question. How many of you have ever used Motorola phones in your life or are still using? So I can see there are very less hands. That is the reason that led to the downfall of Motorola. So I'm sorry. I think that's a good thing. I'll get better marks, I guess. So in this presentation, we would be...
You have asked for hell.
I'm sorry. So in this presentation, we would be considering the following points. We'll first start with the introductions, and then we'll cover the reasons which led to the downfall of Motorola. We'll talk about its acquisition by Google, also its acquisition by Lenovo. We'll also talk about the strategies adopted by Lenovo and its competitors, and in the end we'll conclude what it is current market position. So Motorola was first founded by the two brothers, Paul V. Galvin and Joseph E. Galvin. The initial name of the company was Galvin Manufacturers, and in 1963 it became Motorola. So and manufactured the world's first cell phone. In 2011, due to the Motorola was occurring huge losses in 2007 and 2009, so it got separated into two departments, generally in Motorola Solutions and Motorola Mobility. Motorola Solutions deals with the telecommunication equipment, and Motorola Mobility deals with the mobile devices. Also, on August 15, 2011, Motorola Mobility was acquired by Google. And after 3 years, on January 29, 2014, Lenovo acquired Motorola Mobility. The estimated revenue for the year 2018 was 6,881 crores.
So in this slide, we will discuss about what were the reason that Motorola incurred losses and why did it didn't do good in the market. So the first reason is Nokia takes the lead. Till 1998, Motorola was one of the best mobile manufacturing company in the world. But with the introduction of Nokia in 1998, Nokia takes the lead from the Motorola to become one of the successful mobile manufacturers in the world. Secondly, Motorola missed the movement to 3G, as most of the mobile manufacturers were adopting to 3G services. Motorola decided not to adopt to 3G services and to stick to the old service, due to which its customers moved to other mobile manufacturers so that they can benefit from the 3G services. Reluctance in making Android phones. Since Android is a huge successful in mobile, Motorola wasn't the first mover to adopt the Android. They adopted this operating software after quite a long time, and because of that, their other competitors already had adopted the technology, and due to which it has incurred huge losses. Motorola stopped innovating. In the early 2000s, Moto Razr was one of the best selling mobile of Motorola. And what Motorola did was they just were defending Moto Razr. They weren't inventing anything new like Apple did, like BlackBerry gave their iconic OVT keyboard phones. Motorola was just defending Moto Razr by just introducing a. Motorola was just defending Razr by without giving any new options, without giving any new features, due to which they lagged behind. Running at their own pace, Motorola was never the first mover. Segment. So they took their own time in implementing things, due to which they always lagged behind from the competitors. As my friend said that Motorola incurred huge losses between 2007 and 2009, due to which Motorola was separated into two groups, Motorola Solutions and Motorola Mobility. And in 2011, Motorola was acquired by Google for 56,000 crore. And the benefits of the deal was that it accelerated innovation in Motorola by introducing new phones, but they were not at par level with the other competitors like Samsung and Apple, and also they introduced better phones at low prices, but it didn't affect the market of the Motorola in India. It was still not able to tap the market because Samsung was also launching the Galaxy series, which is one of the successful series of the Samsung.
So in this slide, I'll be talking about its acquisition by Lenovo. So as Lenovo was lacking behind in the technology of making Android-based devices, so Lenovo planned to acquire Motorola Mobility at ₹12,000 crores. So the major benefits of the deal were to strengthen Lenovo's position in the market and also to get the benefit of the Android technology. The various strategies adopted by Lenovo were as follows. Focus on consumer needs. If a company is making products, the company needs to focus on what are the needs of the consumer prevailing in the market. So Lenovo generally focused on the needs of the consumer, like making touchscreen devices and better camera, etc. Adopting the new technology. So as I earlier said, Lenovo was lacking behind in the technology of making Android-based devices. So Motorola adopted making new devices with the help of Lenovo. Increased market knowledge. The second most thing which a company needs to success in the market is the basic marketing knowledge, its competitors and the SWOT analysis, like its strengths, weaknesses, opportunities and threats. So Lenovo did all the things and made better products like Moto, introduced three products like Moto X, Moto G and Moto E. A detailed business plan. So Motorola focused on a detailed business plan. It targeted various segments segments of consumers. Like it introduced three phones, Moto G, Moto E and Moto X, between the ranges of 10, 15 and 20,000. So next slide, please.
So here are the current competitors of Motorola. As you can see the revenues of the competitors, and you can here see the revenue of the Motorola, we can clearly see that Motorola is lacking way behind all these competitors. They are still not able to tap into the Indian markets, and they are way behind the competitors.
So I just want to say one thing, we didn't get much information about the revenues and all and the market share, because Motorola was always in the other segment. So we didn't get the exact information, and in the end we want to conclude that after making such an innovations and joining with Lenovo as well as Google, Motorola didn't succeed in making a desirable, considerable position in the market. Motorola smartphone shipment declined by 70% in 2018. The brand sunk from 6th to 12th spot in the market in 2018. So the major reason was the Motorola didn't refresh its portfolio as compared to its competitors like Xiaomi and others, mid-range smartphone producers. Thank you.
Thank you.